Two Barnabotti with a merchant on the left and a Venetian noble with the household staff named Marisa, and on the rooftop the Venetian spy. On the left is Pantalone for the gifted, next to Brighella, on the back Dottore and Colombina, è il capitano della commedia dell'arte. Take what is theirs. We have put two objective tokens and we need to rescue the enemy objective token. The Patrician win the initiative on the first turn. Barnabotti double moves and end his movement on the bridge. Then, il Capitano use one of his command ability to move two friendly characters in this position. Pantalone and il Dottore takes a better position on the field. Then, il Capitano moves once next to the bridge and try to jump on the rail and with a chain jump end up his movement in this position on the bridge. Next action goes into guard. Then Marisa moved twice. Then also Brighella moved twice and stopped his movement with a clear line of sight. Merchant moved twice. Colombina moves twice. Then the Venetian noble tried to chain jump on the pool and he gets the right amount to safely land 5 inches from the pool. Then he moves again and attempt to shoot at the Capitano. It's actually 5 damage, and with the protection roll we only are able to save one, so it's 4 life point loss. Il Dottore moves and then try to launch the cantrip of the star and is successful. Con Barnabotti attempt to chain jump on the pool and then on the bench. Successful and then fails the second chain jump and fall into water. Pantalone moves, then attempt to chain jump on the rail of the bridge. The first is a critical success and second jump is one ace, so he jumps by 3, lands over there. The Venetian spy moves twice. Second turn, initiative is won by Patricians. And Venetian noble is gonna shoot to Pantalone. 4 successes. Protection roll fails and Pantalone goes down to 7 life points. The Venetian lord with the second action goes back to behind the building and reload his gun. Then the Capitano activates and with his command ability allows Pantalone to move as well with the Dottore moves up to the bridge. So with the first action, he moves 2 inches toward the buildings and use the other 2 inches to go up on climbing. So he makes a dexterity roll, and with one ace, he's able to climb. And then a second action to try climb again, but he fails. A third action to try to climb, and he fails again. But Jacopo was so good to allow me to consider one dice as an ace and climb to the top of the building. The Venetian noble, being in line of sight with Marisa, spends a command point to give her an extra action. She used 2 actions to get in contact with Pantalone and generates an attack of opportunity. And she gets 2 aces. But Pantalone tries a protection roll and gets 1 ace, which means it's 1 damage and is stunned. With the last action, Marisa attacks again and she gets 4 damage, and the protection roll fails, which means Pantalone gets 4 hits and goes down to 4 life points. Pantalone tries to disengage with a dexterity roll and is able to disengage as then moves forward and launch a grenade in between the merchant and the Banabotti. So we roll damage against the Banabotti and it's only one ace. The protection roll save the Banabotti, then we roll against the merchant and his score 3 hits. Plus 1 is 4 damage, then the protection roll saves 1. The life points lost for the merchant that goes down to 8 life points total. Venetian spy activates and moves, then try to jump on the other roof. So makes a dexterity roll and gets 3 ace, which allows her to jump and land safely on the other roof. Brighella decides to shoot at Marisa and he gets 3 aces, plus he can reroll 1 for the expert marksman, so 4 damage, and Marisa can't make any protection roll due to the minus 4 penetration, so she goes down to 8 life points. With the second action, Brighella goes into guard. The merchant moves and uses his common ability to give first strike to the Banabotti. Then in his last action he tries to shoot a Pantalone with his Varian pistol, but he misses. Il Dottore tries to use Gantrip of the Star, difficulty 5, and he gets it. Then he tries to use Maximum Fortune and spending an extra will point, difficulty 4, and that's it, so Brighella can reload his weapon. Banabotti uses 2 actions to get in close combat with Pantalone, and because his first strike goes to first strike 2, plus he spends an additional will point to go up to 7 dice. He scores 6 hits and protection roll only score 1 ace, which is not enough, then Pantalone is out of action. Colombina spends 1 command point to use her command ability and boost her attack characteristics to plus 2. Then she uses her ability to get a will point from Dottore to restore her command ability just spent. Then Colombina tries to jump on the handrail and she scores 2 aces, then chain jumped 3 aces, and she's able to land safely on the other side of the river, but not quite enough to engage Marisa. So she spends the second action to move in contact with Marisa and generates an attack of opportunity. She uses a will point and she scores 4 damage and protection rolls save 2, which means 2 life points lost, and she goes down to 6 life points. The other Banabotti climbs up the river and moves. Third round, the Patrician scores a fumble, so Gifted can win initiative. The Capitano moves on the edge of the roof and then try to chain jump on the back of the lion below. With the first dexterity roll, Capitano is able to score enough successes to complete the jump. With the second jump, which is 3, he fails and he then lands straight next to the Banabotti, generating an attack opportunity. And he uses Effect of Spence to reroll 2 dice. So it's 2 hit plus 2 damage, protection roll it fails, so 4 damage straight to the Banabotti. That goes to 6 life points. But the merchant uses a command point to make the Banabotti activate in the middle of the Capitano actions. He spends a will point and goes to attack 5. And he scores a critical, so 1 life point is gone. plus 4 damage, and with a protection roll, 2 are saved, so 2 hit and 2 left points are gone. Capitano goes down to 6. Then Capitano spend his last action for a combat action, spend another will point to boost his roll, and scores 4 aces. And protection roll saves 1. Arnabot is left with just 1 life point. So Marisa activates and makes an attack to Colombina. She gets 3 aces, but because parry 2 of Colombina needs to reroll 2 ace, so it's now 2 hit instead, and Colombina rolls for protection roll. And she gets to save 2, so no damage, but she's still stunned. Then second action is another attack. It would be 3, but parry 2 makes her roll 2, then it's just 1, and protection roll saves 1. No damage for Colombina, but she is stunned. Brighella tries to shoot at the Barnabotti, and with his long-range crossbow, he can reroll for maximum 2 dice, and he gets 2 damage. Protection roll saves 2, so no damage for the Barnabotti. And then with a shorter crossbow, he tries to shoot at Marisa. Brighella rolls 3 successes, but can roll 1 for the expert marksman. Now it's 4 successes, and because of petition minus 4, Marisa, it goes down to 2 life points, no protection roll. The Venetian spy moves, then shoot to il dottore. She rolls and gets 5 aces plus 1 damage. It's 6 protection roll for the dottore, and it's 5 damage and goes down to 7 life points. The dottore moves and then try to make a maximum fortune magic to Brighella, and it succeeds, so Brighella is now is a flame crossbow reloaded. The Barnabotti attacks back il capitano, and he rolls and gets 3 plus 1 is 4 damage, protection roll doesn't save anything, so the Capitano gets 4 life points lost and goes down to 2 total life points. So he decides to spend a commander point and makes an activation out of sequence to combat back. He can reroll 2 dice because of spell offense. So it's 4, 8 plus 2, 6 damage. Protection roll for the Barnabotti, but no way he can save himself with just 1 life points. And he's definitely now out of action. Colombina spends 1 command point to boost his attack and also spend 1 will point. He's a critical, so it's a total of 6 damage, and protection roll is not enough to save the life of Marisa, which goes out of action. Venetian noble moves twice and gets in close combat with il capitano, generating an attack of opportunity. He scores 6 hits, and there's no way a protection roll could save il capitano, which is removed from the field. And this generates a victory point condition on one of the agenda for the patrician. So they draw another new agenda card. Then with the third action, the Venetian noble shoots at Colombina. He gets 5 damage. Colombina rolls for protection, but he fails, so 5 life points lost, and he goes down to 7. Then the merchant moves twice, same for the Barnabotti. Fourth round. and Patrician won initiative. The Venetian spy reload and then try to shoot al dottore. And she gets 5 damage plus 1. He can reroll 1 for the expert marksman. He can save 1, but he gets 5 damage, so it goes down to 2 life points. Then Colombina spends 1 common point to boost his movement attribute and moves twice closer to the objective. The Venetian noble wants to reach Colombina, so he tries to jump on top of the lion. The first jump scores are critical, so the noble decides to land on the pool and chain jump again, which makes him safely land next to Colombina with his first action, generating an attack of opportunity. He can reroll 1 dice for the expert offense, and because Colombina has parry, can make reroll 2 successes. This is a total of 4 damage plus 1, 5. Protection roll saves 1, so Colombina gets 4 damages, going down to 3 life points total. But this is just first attack, so second attack, he can reroll 1 for the expert offense and needs to reroll 2 for parry. 4 again, a total of 4. She saved 1, so she is gone. Then with the remaining action, the Venetian noble moves. Il dottore moves and then he tries to launch the maximum fortunes to Brighella and is able to reload. The merchant moves and he tries to shoot at il dottore and he spends 2 will point to boost the attack. He has 3 ace, 2 are blocked by the protection roll, so it's just 1 life point lost and goes down to 1 total life point. Then Brighella moves and gets into a clear line of sight to the Barnabotti and shoots. He also spent 1 will point and he scores 5 hits with penetration minus 4, which means the Barnabotti gets 5 damage and it goes down to 6 life points. Barnabotti then moves twice. The Venetian spy shoots at Brighella from the roof and she gets 4 damage. And with protection roll, Brighella saves 1 and goes down to 8. Brighella with his first action reload and then shoot at the Barnabotti using the flaming crossbow. He gets 2 ace and can reroll 1, so 3 damage. Protection is down to 1 dice, but it fails, so the Barnabotti goes down to 2 life points. The Venetian noble moves and try to shoot a Brighella and he rolls 4 successes, 1 is saved, so 3 damage and Brighella goes down to 5 life points. And then the Venetian noble shoots it again, but luckily enough the Brighella only lost another additional life points. Then is the turn of Dottore, which moves, and when in position in line of sight with Brighella, he tries to launch the Marksman Fortune magic, and it was successful, and he was able to reload the flame crossbow. So the merchant behind the corner shoots at the Dottore, and he gets so many aces, no way to save him, and is now removed from prey. So the Barnabotti try a chain jump on the handrail and he made it, so the chain jump again to land very close to the building next to Brighella. And with the second action he moves again, moving around Brighella and hitting it on the back. So attacks of opportunity and he scores 4 aces. The protection roll saves 2. He goes down to 1 life points. And here we decided to stop, as there were no chances for La Commedia dell'Arte to win the game. So Patrician won. Thanks for watching, and please leave a like and subscribe if you haven't done so. That really helps the channel growing.